Right, then, mate. So what we're going to do, whilst the game is going on, should we do our predicted league table for this year? Where do we think teams are going to finish?
Yeah, good shout.
Shall we do it, or is that a bit, you know, like, are we going a bit too far with this?
Honestly, don't mind, mate. It's you. You're the boss.
Right. All right, then. I'll give you the first shout, then.
Yeah.
Where do you want to go first?
So we're doing...
Well, we'll just do a handful of teams at a time, and we'll do it in the alphabetical order that there is. So, you know, Barnsley.
So, Barnsley. So, they surprised me, even though we beat them 4-0. I thought they were quite good. They look like a young team, but they looked quite exciting and stuff. So, I think they'll be nearer the top end. Sorry, I can't see it on there. Is that top 12? Is there a section top 12?
That's top 10. So, you've got champions in second, playoff places. You've also got top 10, below 10th, and also relegation as well.
I'm going to go top 10. I reckon they'll get ninth.
All right. Interesting. All right. Yeah, we'll put...
Do you not agree? Where are they at the moment, Sam? Do you know where they are at the moment?
Oh, mate. Like, why do you always put me on the spot like this? You make me look like such an amateur. Which, to be fair, I actually am.
Barnsley, I've got a feeling that's higher than you think, mate.
Yeah, they are. They're ninth.
Cool.
So, yeah, you called it. So, yeah.
No, I can see them about... But do you agree with me, though, that even though we beat them 4-0, I thought they were quite good, like quite a good football team. They just probably were a bit too naive and let us in.
Well, whilst you were saying, I think it was that little chat we had with Chris Temple after the game against, who was it, Brentford?
Brentford, yeah.
And whilst you were saying that, I mean, you said that, and he was nodding his head as well. And it flattered, you know, because they had a lot of chances in that Barnsley. So, yeah, I'd agree with that.
We'll go and they're the youngest team in the league. So they're the type of team that I think will kind of, they're inexperienced, but the more games they play, do you know what I mean? So, they're almost my little dark horses to try and cause a little scare to the playoffs, actually. But, yeah, I reckon they'll just miss out.
Okay, Birmingham City?
Oh, they are bad. So the bottom one's relegation. What's the one above that? Sorry, I'll go in that section.
Below 10th.
Yeah, they're definitely below 10th, but I think they'll just have enough. I thought they were poor against us. I don't think Birmingham look good at all, but I think they'll probably just have enough to stay up.
And we'll do Blackburn Rovers before we start watching the game again.
We'll go top 10 for them as well, but I think they'll be similar to... But I think they're another team that... Playing them, obviously, first game, so it's difficult to judge, but they've got goals in them, haven't they? Adam Armstrong, I think he's top goal scorer in the league. But they do ship a few. But yeah, top 10 for me. Them and Barnsley just miss out.
Right, here we go. We are going to go and have a look to see where Tom is putting AFC Bournemouth. Where do you think Bournemouth are going to finish this season? Champions and second, playoff places. You can be realistic about it, mate. Head or heart, it's up to you. What are you going for?
I think we'll get champions or second. Let's go for it. Is that a pen? Something always happens when we start talking about that. I'm going to stay confident. I think... it wouldn't surprise me, if I'm being totally realistic here, it wouldn't surprise me if we dropped into the playoffs, but I wouldn't take playoffs if you offered me it. No, I'm going to go championship in a second because I do think we've got enough. I think there's more to come from us. I think we'll have enough. I think Norwich are not looking as everyone thought they're going to run away with it. I'm not so sure on that. I think Buendia might go in this window, which would be big for them. Mm. I think Brentford are a worry because they look good. But I don't think Watford look as good as us. I don't think Swansea look as good as us. I still think we got more to give. And I think we're gonna get in that top two, hopefully.
Okay, Oldham making a substitution at the moment. So it's a bit of a break. So we'll go for another few teams. We'll go Brentford, who, to be fair, they looked impressive, didn't they, when we played them?
I'm going to make a bit of a shout here. I'm going to say us two are going to be the top two. I think Norwich are going to lose Buendia. I think Buendia might go. I think Norwich might have a bit of a blip and might have to settle for the playoffs, personally. I'm going to go for us and Brentford top two.
Okay, well, what we'll do then is I'll put Norwich in there straight away then, but we'll go back to alphabetical order and Bristol City then.
Bristol City, yeah, they're a weird one because they're up there, but, I mean, I wasn't impressed with them when we played them, to be honest. We nicked it near the end, didn't we? Dan Juma, I think it was, 1-0. But... they didn't really give a lot in the game. I thought they'd have... I think they're going to just miss out on the playoffs. Yeah, I'm going to go top 10.
Okay, top 10 for Bristol.
I think that three I've got in the top 10, I think will be 7, 8 and 9th.
And we'll do Cardiff now as well, just before we pop back and watch the game.
They'll be 10th. So that's 10 my... I think I've... Yeah, so that's... I've done 7, 8, 9, 10 there, haven't I? Yeah.
Yeah, that's it. 7, yeah. 8, 9, 10. So we'll decide the other places very yeah. shortly. But let's get back to the stream now to see what's going on. We're going to go through our next four or five teams here. Whilst Oldham go on the attack on the right flank, but looks like it's come to nothing. Goes to the far post, miscontrolled, out for a Bournemouth throw. So Coventry City then, mate.
Are they going to stay up? Just trying to think who would go. Who do I think going to go? Yeah.
Well, they're currently 16, so they're doing all right. They're doing all right.
I think they'll just stay up. Yeah, we'll go in the one above relegation.
Below 10th. Okay, no problem at all. Derby County, Wayne Rooney's Derby County. Had a bit of a renaissance, but then still a few dodgy fixtures every now and then. And they're actually sat 22nd at the moment, beneath Sheffield Wednesday on goal difference. So they're in the relegation zone.
I think they're going down, mate. I watched a bit of them. Yeah, I watched them a bit earlier against Chorley. And don't get me wrong, magic of the cup and all that. And they're obviously trying some players out. But that also proves to me that if they get any injuries, the players waiting in the wings ain't up to it. Do you know what I mean?
Derby are going down.
I think Derby might go down. Yeah, I do.
Hello. Oh, tasty, tasty. Ooh,
Sammy Surridge is coming on.
Sammy Surridge.
He's one of our own. Oh, is that Jeff? Here he is. I'm gonna, Jeff Lerner's coming on as well, the boy.
Oh, the last 10 minutes here could be tasty. Would be nice to see Sam Surridge get a goal as well. Right, Huddersfield Town, mate.
Bottom half, but they'll be fine.
Luton?
Yeah, bottom half, but they'll be fine. Same for them. They're actually doing quite well, but I think they'll drop it to the bottom half. I don't think they've got the squad, but they'll be fine. They'll be fine.
By the way, I can confirm that Craig Beasley has got a guest for Luton.
Yeah.
And if you watch 90s TV, you'll know who it is. And even if you watch TV in the noughties as well, to be fair, and, oh, you know what, I'm not going to say too much, but it's a TV personality that I know, put it that way. Okay. So, yeah, really interested. And there is a Millwall as well, but he's just got some journalists for that, Tom, so... I mean, Brian Cox.
That's cool for Beasley.
Beasley, what are you doing? What are you doing? I'll send him his P45 soon.
Who was the bloke that done that? Who was the old, weren't the old owner or chairman or someone at Millwall? Wasn't he the one on Dragon's Den?
Theo Pafitis.
Theo, yeah. Where's he?
Yeah. Oh, Josh King.
Where's he, Beasley?
He's cut it back too far. Oldham get the
Beasley,
ball.
Beasley, I want Theo on.
Theo Pafitis actually is, would be a good shout for a guest. I remember going to a game against Millwall where he apologized. It was like in March, and he apologized for them having a really poor season. And on the corner of the program, there was a voucher for a free beer, but he extended it to home, to the away fans as well. So you just had to, chop off the corner of your match day program and get a free beer. And it was just to apologize for how poor that they had been. And, I think I was about 17 at the time, so I sort of went on my tiptoes. I'll have a pint of Foster's, please. Deepest voice. And I got a pint out of there. So that was really nice. No ID checks there, never mind. Middlesbrough, mate.
Bottom half.
Right.
Yeah.
Bottom half.
And Only just.
And I'll do another one before we get back to the game.
You just put them in the top half. What are you doing?
There you God. Go. Useful. And then Millwall.
Where are they at the moment?
They are currently sitting in 17th.
I think they might go down.
Do you? What? I mean, at the expense of what? Like Rotherham?
Four go down, don't they?
Three.
Remember? Is that only three? Why am I thinking four? Yeah.
League one to league two.
Yeah, sorry. Yeah, they'll just stay up then. Yeah, sorry. I was thinking like four from bottom. So that'll be, they'll just stay up. Sorry, yeah.
Okay,
so I don't think it's difficult for Millwall, remember, because they're the only team we haven't played.
Yeah, really loving that.
Rhythm is a dancer. Josh King is the answer. He scores goals from everywhere. There you go.
Right, let's go back to it then. Imagine. So,
Forest, we're going bottom half.
Forest, we're going bottom half, are we? Okay, let's put that there. So, let's just make that full screen a little bit. Forest, bottom half, that's below 10th, yeah.
Yeah, below 10, sorry. I have to say the same for Preston, which surprises me because they were good against us, but they haven't been elsewhere.
You know,
so
we can still swap a team out if you're thinking, oh, actually, maybe Bristol City or, by all means, this doesn't have to be the be-all and end-all. If you feel as though there's a team there and you think, actually, I'd quite like to swap that up, absolutely no problem with that. I'll let you do it, Tom, as it's you, only because it's you, but I'll let you do it.
Yeah, I appreciate that, boss. QPR, bottom half, though.
Okay, below 10.
Now I want to switch. I want to switch. I request a switch.
Okay, go on.
Move Cardiff down.
at the expense of Reading?
Yeah, I want Reading. They're just going to miss out on the playoffs, Reading.
Rotherham?
They're going down.
Sheffield Wednesday.
I think they might just stay up. Yeah, just stay up.
Below 10th for them. Stoke City then?
They're getting in the playoffs. I think they're going to nick it. I think they've got experience in there. I think they might just get in there.
I've got a feeling I know how these playoffs are going to shape up, Tom. Swansea now.
Yeah, Swansea and Watford both going in them playoffs.
And that
If I were going to do that in kind of order, I mean, obviously third place sixth and fourth place fifth. We're in here. I know.
Yeah, it's clear.
So I think it will be third Norwich will play sixth Stoke and then Swansea will play Watford. I still think Norwich might have a bit. But yeah, Wickham, I would quite like Wickham to stay up. But I think watching them against us, obviously it's hard. We've only played everyone once apart from Millwall. They're a hard-working team. They'll grind out a few results, but I don't think they've got enough quality. I don't think we were great on the night and we still managed to get past them. So, I think that's Derby's obviously a bit of a rogue shout and so Stoke maybe, but that's bang on. So anyone can disagree if you want, but you're wrong because that's bang on. And that'll be clipped up at the end of the season when they go, oh, Mystic Tom. I'll be in there, maybe a hashtag going and everything. That's my little prediction there, yeah.
So, AFC Bournemouth and Brentford with Norwich, Stoke, Swansea and Watford in the playoffs. What are you thinking about that? Are you agreeing? Are you disagreeing? But Brentford, I mean, they really did impress, I've got to say. And, you know, Norwich, you could argue that when we played them, Tom, there was a bit of an issue with Buendia and Cantwell and they didn't know if they were going to go or stay, but in the end they both stayed. No, that's right. So they weren't at full strength, but...
this is difficult. I think if we were doing this at the end of the window, if they were to keep hold of Buendia, I just got a feeling that Buendia might go, you know. And I think that, even though I'd love to say Brooks or Lewis Cook, if I hand on heart, I think I would probably say that Buendia is the best player in the league. So you can't tell me they're going to be as good without him. So, that's probably my main reasoning behind that. But I still wouldn't be surprised if they come up via the play. I've still got a good squad. Is there anyone in there for obviously it was me that done it. Yeah. Is there anything in there that if I said you could change one, is there anyone you think would, do you agree with that kind of top six in general and teams to go down and stuff like that? What do you think?
Just having a look now, actually. I think, the only shout, maybe. Yeah, I mean.
Could easily be Reading.
Yeah, you know, Reading had such a good start and you just wonder, you know, even, I don't know, I think they, you know what, I'm not sure you're wrong, mate.
I'm not wrong. I was just saying if you want to change it for Rand
I think you are. I can't disagree with that. And people are saying that it's about right, says Keith, and also AFCB John said good shout as well. So yeah, I'm pretty much in agreement, mate. So I'll let you have that. It's been a pleasure today, mate.
Yeah, I've enjoyed it, mate. Really enjoyed it. Like I say, it was a decent game without being a thriller, but enjoyed it and enjoyed doing this. And I didn't expect so many people to kind of be chatting all the way through it and listening to us. That's really nice. Really big compliment. Really do appreciate it. It's really good. And everything we do seems to be supported really well. We've got a nice little, you know, we might not have the fan base of an AFTV and stuff like that, but we've got a real nice bunch, haven't we? So, thanks to all. Really appreciate it.